System of a Down, the Mars Volta, Hella, live this weekend. Be there.
Okay, cool.
So Joe.
Yeah.
Where are we?
We're at Arco Arena. Hometown Sack Show.
What do you think about this?
System of a Down tour. It's like rad for those dudes. They worked really hard to get here. It's pretty awesome.
But when you say those dudes, you're talking about Zach and
Zach
Spencer.
Zach and Spencer, they worked really hard to get here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And you should be getting some effects.
Some effects.
1, 2, 3, 4.
How did this all come together?
Well, I think the Arena Rock organization heard us on the radio, and we fit the criteria, and they asked us to do it.
What's your name?
Zach.
Zach, put this right down on the table so I think we'll look.
I talked to
Zach. What?
Zach Bill.
Hey guys, we can go through everything else that we're waiting for.
So, tell me what the fuck you're doing here. Why are you here?
I don't know. That's actually the main question I've been asking. This thing has made me ask myself really all this stuff, like even these people working and everything about it. Has made me ask a lot of those kind of questions of why I'm, or even what this is and stuff. And actually, main thoughts on my mind right now are like pretty much asking myself how much of this is actually for value of art and progression of, you know, younger kid, you know, to inspire kids and things like that, especially because there's so much money and waste involved in the whole thing. Not to be pessimistic, but there's a huge optimistic side to it too, and I'm very grateful for the situation, but I don't know what I'm doing here, but that's what it's made me ask myself the most. I'm asking myself that question every day.
Banner's hot. You'll have to ask Hill about how many cans of spray paint are on it. You might just come in a little bit on the stage right.
What are you doing on this tour?
What am I doing? What I always do, just whatever needs to be done. So, driving a lot. You know, I deal with all the money and the merch and the settling and like, just trying to, you know, make sure that, I'm just trying to make sure they have everything they need to be able to do their thing. That's mainly it.
Make sure everything's on the level.
Yeah. But I mean, on this, it's just pretty much automatic. You show up, you just make sure you have your stuff ready to go on stage at a certain time, and then, you know, you're there when you're supposed to go on, and those guys do their thing, which is ripping. Let's go inside.
We saved beers for tonight because we knew we were going to have extra guests. And this way, we didn't waste these poor beers. Because after all, they are made to drink.
Is it more weird to be playing in an arena in your hometown?
It's definitely different. It's definitely because, I don't know. I mean, you know, you grow up and...
Let's take that off.
Yeah, bummer. anyway, so you kind of grow up and this is the only arena. So now we're playing at that only arena, and I guess it has more, significance.
There's a small barricade over here, but all of us can't fit in there. If some of you want a seat, I can give you a seat, too. Okay?
Now, I wonder if...
But the floor is going to be great. It's not that full out there. And we go in, like, 11 minutes. So...
Well, what we do need to say, Joe, is after we're done playing, just make sure everyone can get back to the room.
Right, and the way you do that is if you come in through this portal, so you go through the hallway here, okay, there's this portal right here. If you just say, oh, I'm with Hella, and have them direct you through, like, back here to this hallway in this room, and you can even hang in the portal. But the portal, it's the portal to, many parallel universes that I exist in simultaneously.
We can actually probably start putting people out right now, too.
Yeah.
Second to the last show of a 1 month tour, 1 month arena tour, basically 1 month. about that.
Like for like last month, I've just been like following yellow signs that say hella.
It's funny, huh?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It's so weird.
Is there always that many system signs?
Mm-hmm.
And then just the one little hella sign?
Well, they all say System of a Down on because that's the tour.
Right.
So it's like they'll say System of a Down hella.
Right.
System of a Down Mars Volta.
Right.
System of a Down Mars Volta tuning room. System of a Down tuning room. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They all say it some way. All right, this puppy's ready.
Has anything changed from the beginning of the tour compared to now, like as far as the experience?
I'm stoked on the whole experience because it, like, you just learn stuff, you know. It's been a super learning experience for me. There's not a lot of margin for, like, you know, fucking up, though. It's like, it's been hard pushing to stay up with it with the bus tour. You know, you gotta be here early.
A lot of rules.
Yeah, a lot of rules, and I mean, it's rad. I mean, we're getting taken care of super well. It's like a family, this whole, like, organization, like, systems crew, and that's rad. You know, those system dudes have been super rad, and their management's been super rad.
Tell me a little bit about that, as far as, like, last night you were saying something about how they could have taken...
Well, they could have taken, you know, a band that obviously is a lot more well known. Where did you guys go?
Me.
Are you in the bushes? You could have just walked in the door. But...
I know, we wanted to pick flowers.
Yeah, I mean, they could have taken someone that, you know, I mean, they really should be applauded for taking Mars Volta and Hella out, because they could have taken, like, easier choices that, and they would have sellouts every night. And probably for not any more money than what they're paying us. And, you know, I mean, in that way, it's a super rad thing.
How do you really feel here?
Feels pretty reasonable. You know, I mean, I don't know. It actually has the feeling of being back at school, like high school or something, kind of. In that there's like security and like long hallways and hot lunch.
High school teacher, right in the era like that Metallica's Black Album came out. So my mom's kids at school were all like busting the Black Album. That was like huge, you know.
Yeah.
And so she, like, we went to the record store one day. My mom buys, because this was another one of her kids' favorites. My mom buys Tesla 5-Man Acoustical Jam and Metallica's Black Album, and those were busting my house all the time. My mom's the only person in my household to ever bring a Metallica album in the
house. She was just ripping them.
Oh yeah. It wasn't like, oh, I like the
was
single.
Was it like an attempt at relating with the kids, kind of?
No, it wasn't like that. She just was stoked on the record. She was super
high.
She
heard it all the time or something?
Yeah, because the kids played it all the time, and she just got stoked on it.
You told me another record that your mom always used to blast.
Oh, dude, Fleetwood Mac the Dance.
Yeah.
That was later. Ask John Mattson about that. That really freaked him out.
Did it melt your taint?
It really freaked my brain out, dude. Because it was on, my mom's the type of person, you know, the listeners that once they are into something, it just is constant.
Mm-hmm.
So basically that album was basically on repeat for a good, like, 2 years. The Dance.
Like Scoob.
Loud.
The Dance.
Because she's outside working in the garden. It really freaked my brain out, dude.
It is a big deal, but then sometimes people almost act as if it's weirder than it really is. Do you sort of feel like that?
I don't know.
I think
it's a big deal because it's big. You know? I thought it was gonna feel weird, like, at, you know, hearing their first sound check where you can hear everything bounce off the back wall, but I think when you're playing, it's just like any other show. Except for there's no people like hitting your effects and stuff, you know, because they can't get that close. You know what I mean?
You guys are gonna get messed with by security tonight, but just try to be super cool. It happens every night.
Come on closer, guys. If people are crowd surfing, I don't want you to grab people, okay? I want right here, okay? I want one person, one hand on their back, one on their mouth. That way when they pull them back, they slide out, and not like that. Get what I mean?
I think, like, it's been pretty, like, constant. I mean, you know, it's hard. I mean, I'll definitely tell you, the nights where we actually can physically sound check, they're more comfortable. I mean, it's hard when you just get a 3-minute line check and then you're rushed off the stage. But I mean, you know, the guys we're working with that are helping us have been really, like, helpful. And I think it sounds good, and I think people are stoked on it.
Justin Stewart.
I can get the same thing playing by myself at home, or dropping out of society and going to the desert and playing by myself every day. And that's what truly makes me happy in the purest form of playing music. But then when all this other stuff gets evolved, it's great too, but at the same time, it makes you ask you why you need to do these things in front of people, or why all these other things have to be attached. You know, and basically it kind of, like, well, there's a couple answers to that, but one of them is like a dark truth. Problems with, and it's been a battle. And then the other is, you know, the, you know, romanticism. Well, that kind of sounds delusional, because it's not necessarily a delusion, but like the, you know, the thinking of that you're actually trying to innovate things and innovate, you know, for progression in a kid's mind, like just how, like, my favorite bands did to me and stuff. But then it's kind of a snowball of just sometimes it's hard to find the sense in all of it, really. Or maybe there's not supposed to be, but I don't know.
I guess
it's a weird thing, because it's like, yeah, there's more people every night that are seeing you, but you know, there's people to see you any night when you play a show. I guess it's just more of, you know, a better chance for more people to be subjected and accustomed to what you're doing. I don't know. I think we're not really, like, nervous, you know, as a band, only because we're not playing stuff that needs to be played perfectly or a certain way, you know? And so, and, you know, we're fairly confident in what we're doing and what we have to offer, so I don't think it really matters what size room or whatever we play, you know, as far as it feeling weird or awkward.
Are you guys okay with everything up there?
I think so.
Oh, I guess so.
Spencer. Huh. If you could compare yourself to any rock or mineral or gem, what would it be?
Gravel. I guess that's multiple minerals or rocks.
I just can't fit into one category, dude. Fucking gravel.
Pea gravel?
Yeah, oh, for sure.
Conglomerate.
Maybe like Gorgonzola gravel?
Gorgonzola. What about you, Dan?
Probably sulfur.
I agree.
Hey, Jonathan.
Hi.
Dan has a question for you.
Well, I don't really know how to answer that. In all the research I've done on that particular topic, I'd say I still haven't found anything wrong with beans.
What about Beanie Babies?
I have a couple. I have a pug and I have the anteater.
Would you say that God gave it to you?
The Beanie Baby?
Yeah.
Well, I thank God for all my bounty. So yes.
You mean your beanie bounty?
My beanie bounty.
That's right.
My Thai beanie bounty.
Super proud of you.
Do you like it when your cape looks more like a bib or do you like it over your shoulders? Because right now it's looking more like a bib. Not that it's a cape, really. It's more like it's a shoulder plate.
It actually kind of like.
What would you call that?
It's kind of like a heating element, I think, because it acts as a layer of clothing in a lot of ways, because it comes up on your neck a ways, you know, and it actually heats you up almost like another layer would, another full layer, except for it's just like a little. Like a toddler, dexterous, congruent layer. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. it's a thing. Just like your little things on your feet, you know? Sometimes you wear them, sometimes you don't. Pretty nice out here.
Church, don't be mad!
it's hard for me. I've really figured it out lately. Like being on like a tour like this, where you get like so much like things, like inspiring things happening, whether it's those guys playing or other bands playing or just people that you meet that, you know, have inspired you in the past or whatever. And then to kind of just be in the mode of like driving, showing up, moving shit around, getting ready, you know, as opposed to being able to like do anything like creative, for me, it's sort of a bummer. Cause I can wax into my, you know, completely self-aggrandizing, you know, creative process, line of bullshit philosophy, or I can be just like, you know, sadly realizing that I have no talent at all. You know, the whole seeing the horizon, but can't find the path. I don't know, I swing back and forth between those two. As far as the tour, it's awesome. Things are awesome. These guys play great every night. It's really something. And the show's amazing too. Especially when he like pulls down his drawers.
I pull them down so people know what I'm talking about.
Because if they know what you're talking about, they'll never forget, right?
Oh, they'll never give me my guts back.
Why wouldn't you get arrested though?
I wouldn't really be exposing myself because the hair is like another layer. It's like clothing pretty much.
What's your favorite word?
Arlington. Through the grapevine. Underdogs. I don't know. I would say Gatefold Vinyl, Guts Arlington, Mom's Guts Gross Guts. What did you say?
You really have that area of a butt?
That's like...
Mine's kind of hairy, I think. That's
you're
weird.
You're listening
to
the bomb?
I'm not like 100% sure what my ass looks like.
Looks great.
Johnny Dang is a camp molester.
Best job you ever had?
Right, he's thinking about getting that job again.
Yeah.
You just missed the summer though. You're gonna have to wait. Unless you go to the Southern Hemisphere.
It's a viable option.
Australia.
Yeah. They don't care that much. That'd be a great film. Just watching Jonathan on his endless summer. I'm for endless summer, but basically he's just going to like be a camp chasing summer.
Chasing summer.
That would be great.
Summer or bust.
That's actually what the film would be called. It's called Chasing Summer.
I love that.
And it's you just traveling around the world from a camp counselor.
I knew a girl named Summer once.
Would the cover be him with like a sunset like on a desert scene?
And a little
with a little sign like stood up against his bag in mid hacky sack, like the behind one where he's like that and like looking like.
And it's a silhouette. It's a silhouette.
Give me that again. Give me the hacky sack.
It's a silhouette of him hacking.
I can't insert my shoulder.
But he's holding a little girl's hand.
Yeah, I don't know if that was hacky thing. I don't. I think this is a different part of my life.
Family spectate the fight, full of paranoia and their lymph nodes.
am I here? I don't know. That's what's making me think about. Basically, I think about it every day when I'm going, getting a fucking an emergency and a water, and people and everybody's. I just don't know how much of this has to do with playing music. I mean, it all does, because they, you know, could ask any of these people, you know, whatever, if I decided, if any person that played music decided to incorporate or use the, or muse this whole situation, which I guess I have and do, then it does have a lot to do with music, because you mused it and then it's like involved in what you're with, what you're doing, but at the same time, you're, I don't know, it's tricky. It's a real bizarre thing. But basically that's where I'm at right now.
I like it though. It's what, fun. It's, you know, it is.
What is the funnest thing about it?
I don't know. It's been fun having people, you know, friends come to see it, because I would definitely like be pretty like weirded out and think it was pretty funny to see like my friend's band, you know, play where we're playing. So
you suck.
That's a weird thing. Right?
That's
funny.
It was awesome.
It was
seriously good. It's like the weirdest thing I've ever seen, maybe, and you just gotta watch.
I'm just stoked because that's like a fucking funny ass thing for like
yeah,
a bunch, like, an arena full of kids to, like, be subjected to.
Because obviously we hear it, like these super strict songs and stuff, but, like, them are just like,
yeah.
What happened?
But the people who know those from the records are fucking stoked.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. It's hard to pick those kids out.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's a great story about some Pit kids who were, like, really into it and, like, started Pit, and then, like, 2 minutes later in the song, they got bored and started playing the song.
Really?
Like they thought they were stoked for a second. Like it sounded stoked, and then they were like, "Oh wait, this is lame."
Yeah.
And they just like started. Then they just stood there the rest of the show like that.
Yeah. Do you think they're into it when there's like a beat that they can like move their body to?
No,
like
there's never a beat.
Probably.
Sometimes.
That's pretty rad. Just seeing like people laugh about the whole thing. Laugh. I mean, you can laugh about The Matrix or butter, you were saying macaroni and cheese, but you can't laugh about this, you know, like not even at all. I do like hot lunch though. Exercise, it'll be free.
Kind of think about that I can say anything serious about is about the creative process, and it's supposed to be, it's the way that we quantify ourselves and evaluate who we are to become like really ourselves, and it's so individual and it needs to be really cultivated. That moment is like where you can find yourself, I think. I think that's where you can focus on. That's where I'm gonna look next.
Get out of here with the camera. He's not here. Have you ever been to this on here?
The stuff was falling apart anyway, so I just said,
I maybe should do something about this. Maybe I'll go get it cleaned by the another place.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. I got a cut I should probably get cleaned up.
Okay, let's deal with it.
Yeah, it sounds like Daft Punk.
Doesn't it?
Yeah.
That's sick, dude. This is hot. What is this? Oh, nuggets.
This fucking hella rocks, baby!
I'll see you guys tomorrow.
I didn't mind that move at all.
Live on the side. Subsonic and starting off the show tonight with a little bit of Daft Punk, the song Robots Rock. Has anyone noticed that that song has become the official song that's okay to play in between bands at big concerts? You know how one of those big shows...